Hello there. Whether you're managing a personal brand or a small business, you know the value of a well-designed website. But today, we're talking about a website element that sometimes doesn't get the attention it deserves, the footer. Yes, your website footer is a vital part of its design, and the good news is, you can customize it in WordPress with a few simple steps. But before we jump into editing the footer, let's first understand what a footer is. The footer is a static section located at the bottom of your website, appearing on all pages. In this space, you often see essential information about the website, such as contact details, social media links, and copyright information. Most WordPress users don't see any value in footers and often overlook them, but they're an essential website element you can leverage for the following benefits. Footers enhance user experience. They provide essential links and resources to guide visitors and keep them engaged. Branding thrives in footers. Build trust and professionalism by displaying contact details, copyright notices, and social media links. By displaying internal links to your footer, you're not only making navigation easier for users but also guiding search engine bots in indexing your website, improving rankings, and increasing traffic. One thing to note here is that WordPress often includes a footer credit with the message, "Powered by WordPress." Now, to your visitors, this default text can appear less than professional and a bit out of place. That's why it makes sense to want to get rid of it, and you can. Instead of the default text, you can customize it according to your needs, whether you want to display your logo, a tailored copyright notice, or a direct link to your privacy policy. Let me walk you through the steps of editing your WordPress website's footer. You can transform your website's footer with the built-in theme customizer feature. It allows you to add new navigation links, adjust the color scheme, and say goodbye to the "Powered by WordPress" message. Log into your dashboard and then navigate to Appearance, then Customize. You'll find yourself in the customizer interface, where you can make changes to your current theme. Keep in mind, though, that the options for customizing your footer might vary depending on your theme. In our case, we're working with the storefront theme. Find a footer tab and click on it to access multiple customization tools. You'll find dedicated fields for background color, heading color, text color, and link color. You can tweak and refine to match your brand colors. With the live preview feature, any changes you make are immediately reflected in your WordPress footer. Adjust the settings until they perfectly match your website's design. Remember to click Publish to save your changes. Let's explore another method for editing footer content, using widgets. WordPress widgets serve many functions, and you can place them in various locations, including the sidebar and footer, provided your theme supports these options. To begin, navigate to Appearance on your WordPress dashboard, then click on Widgets. In the footer section, locate and click the plus icon. You'll see a pop-up widget panel with various content blocks to incorporate into your footer. Let's try selecting the image block. This allows us to introduce your business logo and a concise paragraph to provide visitors with more information about your company. Upload your website's logo, either from your media files or directly from your computer. After adding the image, press the Enter key on your keyboard to introduce a new paragraph section. Here, you can craft a brief yet concise description of your brand. Don't forget to click the Update button to save your changes. For a visitor's perspective, open one of your website pages to view how the footer widget appears. This ensures that the widget appears exactly where you want it to be. The customization possibilities don't end here. You can follow the same process to include additional footer widgets, such as a footer navigation menu and a compelling call to action, or CTA. Let's take a moment here to talk about Bluehost WonderBlocks. Bluehost, a leader in website hosting and recommended by WordPress itself, has introduced WonderBlocks that offers a selection of block patterns and page templates. This means Bluehost users can add custom footer blocks and edit them using WonderBlocks. Even better, you can customize these footers to match your preferences and your brand's unique style. To get started, go to your WordPress dashboard and click on Pages, then select Add New. Look for the WonderBlocks button at the top left corner and click it. You'll discover a variety of custom blocks to choose from for your new page. Navigate to the search bar and type footer. Browse through the selection of designs and click on your preferred footer block. Bluehost WonderBlocks will instantly apply the block at the end of the page. But there's more. Easily customize each block, from text to background color, to make it uniquely yours. Isn't it just fantastic? With Bluehost WonderBlocks, you can edit your WordPress footer in just a few clicks. Manually modifying the WordPress footer.php file is the most complex method. But if you have the coding knowledge, you'll be able to tailor your footer as much as you can. We strongly recommend not modifying the code lines within footer.php directly. Instead, create a child theme and apply your desired changes to the corresponding footer file within this child theme. This ensures you don't lose your original theme if you mess up your modifications. For detailed information, check out our video about WordPress child themes and how you can create one. For added security, you can also comment on the code within the footer.php file. To do this, log into the WordPress admin dashboard. Within the left-hand menu, navigate to Appearance and select Theme File Editor. In the list of theme files displayed on the right, search for the file named Theme Footer or footer.php, and then click it. You can also use this method to remove the Powered by WordPress message. First, select the theme you're currently using. Carefully search through the file to locate the Powered by div class and delete it. We advise you to create a backup of your site or at least the footer.php file before making changes. Now, save the edited file. This should remove the Powered by message on your WordPress footer. While WordPress makes it relatively simple to change the footer credit, the process can be elusive for those new to it. But there are several WordPress plugins to streamline this task, such as Remove Footer Credit plugin, Footer Mega Grid Columns, and Header Footer Code Manager. In this tutorial, we'll use the Remove Footer Credit plugin. To start, log into your WordPress admin panel. Hover over Plugins in the left-hand menu and select Add New. Search for the Remove Footer Credit plugin. Once you locate the plugin, click Install and then Activate. Now, if you want to modify the footer on your homepage, head over to that page and locate the footer section. Right-click on the footer element and choose Inspect. Inside the Developer Tools, under the Elements tab, locate the theme credit and any Powered by WordPress code snippets. Copy the code snippet. Now, head to Tools and select Remove Footer Credit in your WordPress dashboard. Paste the copied code snippet into the Step 1 field of the plugin. In the Step 2 field, enter any text or code you want to display in the footer section. Next, click the Save button. And there you have it. This straightforward process will remove the WordPress footer credit and the theme credit text in your page footer. This brings us to the end of our video. These methods should allow you to edit and customize your footer however you like. Remember, your website is a reflection of both you and your brand, and even the footer, though seemingly small, plays a significant role in enhancing its overall user experience. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Until next time, happy editing and happy website building. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more WordPress-related tutorials.